Welcome to another episode of Back to Basics. Hi, my name is Deval Parikh, and today we will be talking about modernizing legacy monolithic applications into microservices using the Cloud Strangler pattern. Legacy monoliths are complex systems that grow over time to become tightly coupled and are prone to break easily with new changes. This goes against the paradigm of agile development methodology, and organizations today are looking at embracing microservices architecture. So, how do you then break down a legacy monolith application into a microservices architecture? Very often, the answer that you hear is the Cloud Strangler pattern. A Strangler pattern is a way of migrating legacy monolith application incrementally by replacing its existing functionalities with new microservices in a phased approach. Over time, the new microservices replaces all of the legacy system's features, strangling the old system and allowing you to decommission it. This pattern was coined by the legendary Martin Fowler in 2004 after observing the Australian strangler fig vines in the rainforest. These fig vines intertwine and grow around their host tree, eventually killing it to self-support themselves. Let's talk about the approach. There are a few schools of thoughts in how you can break down your monolith into microservices. One way to approach this problem statement is to look at the monolith at a high level and identify all business functions it serves. Assume you have a monolith application with four main functions: vendor management, customer management, content management, and user management. Therefore, our first iteration will break down the monolith into four discrete microservices. This is a highly simplified architecture for the sake of conceptual simplicity. In your next iteration cycle, you can then break down each of the microservices into its own subset of functions based on principles of autonomy and independence. Of course, there are other ways to break down this monolith: by technical modules or client groups that serve a specialized set of functions. Now, let's take a look at an end-to-end architecture. If you have your monolith application on-prem, you can choose to host it on an Amazon EC2 compute instance, or you can deploy it as a container image on Amazon Elastic Container Service. If you are deploying this on ECS, you would create a task definition and a service to host the container instance. You would also want to employ an application load balancer like the AWS Elastic Load Balancer to act as a dispatcher between your old monolith system and new microservices. The ELB will route incoming requests either to the legacy application or to the new services and ensures the legacy application continues to function side by side with microservices. Once routing is established, you can start carving out your old functionality from the monolith and refactor code to build new microservices. You would deploy these microservices on ECS by creating new tasks. You can also create path-based rules on ELB to route incoming requests either to the legacy or the new microservices. As more features are carved out of monolith into microservices, the monolith is strangled and eventually becomes obsolete. You can then safely retire or decommission your legacy system. When building new microservices from your legacy monolith, think about separating data domains associated with each new functionality to be served by purpose-built databases. Now, let's take a look at some of the anti-patterns associated with this solution delivery. Here, breaking up the work into small discrete microservices from the very beginning may be ill-advised. That's not to say you shouldn't separate tiers to optimize the frequency of change and deployment, but any premature optimization and building in unnecessary complexity isn't the right starting point. Therefore, you should aim to shrink and refactor components over a period of time with a focus on continuous improvement. In addition, you must intentionally simplify components so they can be easily managed by small, independent, autonomous teams. Finally, one should seek to apply fundamental principles of DevOps and agile development methodology as you iterate over time. If you'd like to see a full demo of this solution and dive deeper into this architecture, please check out my link below. Thank you for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.